There is a special reward, but the most important thing is the 9 days of Zulhijjah, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to do more. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, these 9 days, the special thing on this 9 days of this Zulhijjah is that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Shaitan, I've never been disappointed, never belittled, and never put into shame like that day. The day of Arafah, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ma kana shaitan asgar wa ahkar wa aygaz. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Shaitan was very annoying because of this 9 day, the day of Arafah. Why? Shaitan, why will you be disappointed? Why will you be angry? وَمَا ذَٰلِكَ إِلَّا لِمَا يَرَى مِنْ تَنَزُّلِ الرَّحْمَةِ عَلَىٰ عِبَادِهِ. Because Shaitan will be very disappointed, very upset, because of the way you see Allah is sending His rahmah upon Muslims. And the way Allah وَتَجَاوُز اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَىٰ ذُنُوبُ. The way Allah will be forgiven the sins of His people. Shaitan will be disappointed and said, wow, I took 1 year to make all these people, some of them, to commit sin. But today Allah has forgiven them. Then I have to start working again. So you can see the reason why Shaitan has been disappointed. But how can you be among those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be forgiving that day? Those who went to Hajj, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made it clear. The day of Arafah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come at the first heaven and said, all of you in this Arafah, you are forgiven. What about we, those who didn't make it? We still have the chance. What is the chance? We have to fast that day and we have to do zikr that day. And then the rahmah will touch all of us. May Allah give us courage to do that. May Allah accept our prayers. Ibadallah, we take it lightly. Hajj. Some people don't take it important to go to Hajj. Wallahi, is very, very important, especially those who are living in this Western world. When you make intention, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you. وَعَنْ لَيْسَ لِلْإِنسَانِ إِلَّا مَا سَعَى. Human being will not achieve anything except what you stand for. When you stand, you make intention to go to Hajj, Allah will help you. So we have to try in as much as possible in our lifetime to answer this call, so that we shall be among those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive their sins. And I advise people in these last 10 days to be able to do more salat ala nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When you are doing zikr, don't forget salat ala nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, people, when they do salat for me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will do 10 salat for you. Ibadallah, this is wonderful advantage, we have to take it. People who went to Hajj, there is no problem to join Hajj and Umrah. And then Umrah, and during your Umrah, you visit Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Medina. There are two advantages being in Medina. Praying in the Masjid Nabawi is big advantage. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, any salah that been offered in my masjid, I'll reward more than every masjid you pray, except Bayt al-Haram. Every salah you perform in my masjid have big reward. Allah will reward you without imagine. That is the first advantage. Second advantage, by you visiting the grave of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and say salam to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when you are saying salam to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you have problem. No, any human being don't have problem. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept your problem and intercede with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah said in the Quran, وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ إِذْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ ثُمَّ جَاءُوكَ فَاسْتَكْفَرُوا اللَّهِ وَاسْتَكْفَرَ لَهُمْ الرَّسُولِ لَوَجَدُوا اللَّهَ تَوَّابًا رَحِيمًا. We have to think about this ayah. This ayah is very, very important. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told mu'mineen, ولو أنهم had they been مؤمنين إذ ظلموا أنفسهم when they committed sin, when they commit the wrong themselves. Allah used the word ظلموا أنفسهم, they wrong themselves, because when you commit sin you wrong yourself, because you are going to hellfire. Didn't you wrong yourself? That's why Allah used that word. Nothing will touch Allah when you commit sin. What will affect Allah? When you commit sin is for your own problem. That is why Allah is ظلموا أنفسهم. When they wrong themselves and they committed sin, فاستغفر الله and ثم جاءوك and they come to Prophet Muhammad. We should listen to this ayah carefully. We shouldn't take it lightly, brothers. This is a wonderful ayah Allah is telling us. They wronged themselves. They committed sin. Mu'mineen, those who see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. ثم جاءوك and they come to you, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. واستغفر الله and they say استغفر الله. They say استغفر الله. And they come to you and ask Allah, Prophet Muhammad, tell Prophet Muhammad to ask Allah to forgive me my sin. That's what the ayah mean. Now, when sin can be asked through Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لَوَجَدُ اللَّهَ تَوَّابَ الرَّئِيمَ, and that sin will be forgiven. At that time, the hajj of Muslimin, their problem at that time is they want Allah to forgive them the sin. So the same thing every human being asks is haja. So when you tell, if Prophet Muhammad will be alive, all of us will be running to Prophet Muhammad to tell him our problem, isn't it? Yeah. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, when you come to Medina and your problem, you say it and you intercede with me, لَوَجَدُ اللَّهَ التَّوَّابَ الرَّحِيمَ, the same thing, your problem will be solved. This is the advantage. Prophet Muhammad is for those people who pass, those people who are living, and the people who are coming. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Hayati khayrun lakum. My being alive is good for you. Wa mamati khayrun lakum. When I die, it's still good for you. I am the same Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I am working to say, I am working. That is why it's